When we were little, fireflies wandered from Fairmount Park to 22nd Street. Divine flying flares floating frivolously through air, they made North Philly look like Times Square. They never had a reason not to love us or trust us, so they would fly over to us and land directly in our palms. But we were insecure adolescents, afraid they'd never bring their light back to us, so we captured them like slaves and we put them in a jar. We placed grass at the bottom, poked holes in the top, and showed them off to all our friends like, look what I got. These hallowed heavenly halogens turned mayonnaise jars into bottled thunderstorms. We lassoed lightning, played God to these beaming beetles. With no thoughts of wrong or right, we just wanted to harness their light, if only for one night. By morning, their light reluctantly dimmed like hope in Hades. I never took responsibility for it. I thought it was natural for electric angels to burn out like dollar store bulbs. They too, they stopped trying to fly. They stopped trying to climb. A once radiating rebellion turns to dim light. They never make it to their third night. Apparently, you can die from despair. Apparently, you can die from not being able to fly. Lightning bugs are claustrophobic. Ask me how I know. Have you ever had your wings clipped like it was for your own good? Like your freedom was a fungus? Like you being you was wrong? You trapped in a jar made of guilt trips and loaded questions? You can't figure out whether you're in love or you suffer from Stockholm syndrome? You loving, trusting someone who doesn't give you what you need to survive because they don't want to see you fly? Just stay there, there in perpetual purgatory, there your light stowed below like luggage. You can only use it if you're leaving. There is no use for your light at home. Home begins to look like North Philly, West Philly, Harlem. There is gentrification in your bedroom. It forecloses your spirit. It garnishes your fight. It repossesses your freedom. It puts a lien on your light. Rent becomes something you can barely pay. Can't leave, can't stay, but can't keep your head above water. So you scratch and survive with thoughts of good times, trying to forget that at one point you could fly. Have you ever had your light accessorize someone's life like a Coach bag? Ever have your flight put on display like poached ivory? They love you for what you have, but they hate you because you have it. They love you when you have light. They hate you once they steal it. They forget that a lightless lightning bug is nothing more than a pest. They love you. They say they love you just the way you are. They say they love you. They love you just the way you are. They love you. They say they love you just the way you are. They love you. You're perfect. Now change. They hate you in all the ways you are. Love you in all the ways you aren't. They despise and destroy the very things that made them fall in love with you in the first place. And then they're like, look what I caught. It's amazing and disheartening how self-destructive human beings can be sometimes. We destroy what we love. We enslave what we admire. We knock back in the nail that sticks out, then complain when it's just another brick in the wall. Have you ever tattooed your tears on your tongue to swallow your pride in the name of love? Ever decided that it's pointless to attempt flight? Because it's not really flying if you're only on a long leash. No matter how much space you give something to breathe, there is no replacement for feeling free. Lightning bugs are claustrophobic. Ask me how I know.